DPP, who is, what is the official name of the DPP? The Director of Public Prosecutions.
Yes.
Yeah. She's kind of been a little bit annoyed with some of us who say her claim, or they claim that her office is soft in corruption and she's, or the office is disingenuous. So she described that as mischievous allegations that her office was soft, and called on the individuals making the claims to cease and desist from pursuing this disingenuous practice.
They're not saying her office is disingenuous, they're saying, I'll turn on the light.
You know, maybe they might fix me up to my position different.
Is who do it? JPS having a problem? Is he over there?
Mm.
Okay. Righto.
Yep.
So she says, I've in the past sought to explain in the public domain and to relevant authorities the true nature and character of these matters, and in fact on request forwarded a full report to Parliament on May 6, 2015, seeking to correct the misperception and explain the true position. So she wants to emphasize that these 40 odd referrals from the OCG, which they're speaking about, are not corruption cases. The administrative breaches which don't disclose any allegations of any ingredients of any corruption offence. She's always under pressure though, and she's been under some serious pressure since news broke of the...
Yeah, I think this is what is causing
what's
this.
What's her name?
Carlos
Cash
Hill.
Plus, the Cash Plus case. People are saying, you know, maybe she didn't do all her research and the case wasn't ready and all the rest of it.
And then last night on All Angles, apparently some of the lawyers were suggesting that
Wednesday night.
They were suggesting that maybe he could have been charged for other offences. I remember we asked that question also. But the deputy director was suggesting that they couldn't.
Which she says, as much as the criticisms come forward, she's going to try to address them, to disabuse the public of this unfortunate perception, which seems to be insinuating that the DPP and its officers have some sort of entrenched inertia in the prosecution of corruption cases, because she says that is absolutely not the case. Okay.
What happened to Rihanna? Who giving Rihanna a hard time?
Just people, I guess. Because people are mean.
Saying what they say?
You're fat shaming her. Sports writer.
What do you mean by fat shame?
Chris Spagnuolo, who's a writer at a place called Barstool Sports, wrote a piece on Tuesday where he criticized her for gaining weight. Says she weighs, estimated that she weighs 180 pounds and worried that other hot girls
that's Rihanna
follow
right
her
there?
Lead and look like they're wearing sumo suits.
That picture is Rihanna right there?
I don't know. Who knows? They might have touched it up. They may not have touched it up. Why don't you just leave her alone? Just leave her alone.
Then, but she couldn't.
People are either too skinny or they're too fat.
No, but I'm suggesting that she wouldn't cause herself to be like that if she wasn't comfortable with herself.
She need flour.
Yeah.
Chris Spags, you need flour. She, all right. If she wanted tomorrow, she can go and fix it. That's the thing with these stars, you know. Sometimes they just allow themselves to get to that place another time when they know it's showtime and they're ready to hit the road and stuff. You look at them and they're like half of where they were before.
Yep.
But in addition to being a performer, she's a human being though, and fat shaming is not okay for any human being. Whether is that Buju on her shirt? Oh no, they look like Buju. Is it?
Yeah, it looks like Buju, yeah.
Is it really?
It looks like Buju to me, yeah.
Does it? It look ish like Buju-ish. Is it Buju? Okay, Jody says Buju.
What it say?
Jody
what
knows
it say?
It all. I don't know. Can't see anything on the other side. Go on, Ariana, you look good with
wait,
the weight.
Tell me again, Unique. I never hear what you say. Unique? You gone?
She gone.
Oh, they said rumor is she's sampling Buju's music on her latest single.
Oh.
What? When you say sampling the music, what does that mean, please?
It means that you go down to Coronation and you say, can I taste a piece of that music? And the lady who's selling give it to you. I sample it, you taste it, and then you buy it.
So she know the person at Coronation Market?
Mm-hmm. Oh. Baby, did she come from, you know, just down the road from Curry. For the regular shop.
Oh, okay. It's time for birthdays? Happy foolish is you talk?
Me? Pay foolish is me talk?
Happy birthday to my son, Rajay Brown. Well, not my son, but Rajay Brown. His birthday is on Saturday. Roger, it's coming from your mom, Tanisha, your stepdad, Paul, your sister, Janae, your auntie, Monique. And also, it's your mom's birthday on Sunday, June 4th. Tanisha. Tanisha used to work at Grace Kennedy. She doesn't work here anymore.
Hi, Maria Lewis. I know you're watching. Good morning.
Yeah, so happy birthday to Tanisha. Happy birthday to Mrs. Rutherford, whose birthday is also tomorrow. It says from best friend Dexter and the Greater Portmore Seventh-day Adventist Church. Happy birthday to Tipper. I'm told that Tipper is 50 years old today.
Which Tipper?
Dancer Tipper.
Which 50?
Just Sharon Short. I just sent me a message and said, happy birthday to Tipper. And
she
said Tipper is 50. See Tipper right here. Everybody knows Tipper. Him is the dancer. Sharon just said it to me, so I trust Sharon. Anything Sharon tells me is gospel.
Right? Anything well, Tipper, whatever you're doing.
See there, Tipper, 50 years old.
Is that spirulina? Do you guys know? Buy from Viva.
And then these beautiful twins here. This is Roger and Rojan Mendes. And their birthday tomorrow also. And it's coming from your mom, Nadine, your sister.
Oh, bless your heart, guys.
Sister Rodine and the rest of the family. Roger and Rojan. Have a great day tomorrow. And also, happy birthday to Sophia, who works with, what do you call it, the fire, I don't think she's a firefighter, but she works with the...
Fire department.
She works with the fire department. So, you can't call me dog.
I just did it.
Have a great day today. Many happy
birthdays. One more birthday before we go. Owen Hansen is asking, Owen is one of our smile jammers, that we say happy birthday to his mom, Marva Thomas, coming from Owen and your seven kids. So Mrs. Marva Thomas, have a great day today. I think, Unique, you should cue back the Friday music so we can dance the folks out to break, because they really did enjoy our rendition this morning. And I don't think we should go to break. I mean, obviously we're gonna have the birthday pictures, but if you cue back up the Friday music then, you know. Because there's some people who can't get out of bed. We have a service to do. Our capes are in the back, but we are Friday people. We're here to get you out of bed.
So what do I do after this?
Good morning to my doctor. Thank you for the drugs yesterday, Shane. I feel so much better. Happy birthday, everybody.
Happy birthday, everyone.
Oh, you're clearing the
set. Yeah, man. It's not a problem. Take up everything.
But we need the table.
My rosemary,
what's happening here?
Here
we go.
Yeah.